Welcome, welcome from Munich. We are here in Germany with the HTC One A9, a beautiful smartphone that's not a premium phone by HTC. It's not a successor of the M9. That's why it got a different letter in the name. But it's definitely one of the most beautiful devices, again, HTC has built, with a few little glitches, like, for example, there is, again, way too much border around the bottom and top part. But otherwise, we have a really quite nice slim design, 7.3 millimeters, a 2150 milliamp battery, and an expandable internal memory. That's also, of course, quite great if you are not satisfied with 32 or 16 gigs. 16 gig version is not available in all countries with 2 gigs of RAM, but there's also the 32 gig, for example, in Germany with 3 gigs of RAM, and it's running really fast here, not on Android 5.1 like you would accept or expect from other devices. Also, here we have already the latest Android Marshmallow 6.0 software with a little bit of the Sense optimization UI on the surface. So it looks, of course, like an HTC phone, but actually there's a lot of Android inside when it comes to also design, because HTC surprised us with their announcement that after 15 days, and when a Nexus device gets an update, for example, HTC will provide for this A9 also an update with the same new, of course, software update. So you can see here on the device, on the side, we have two little ports for the nano SIM card slot and the micro SD card slot. On the bottom, we have the micro USB port with a microphone, also headset jack and a speaker. It looks a little bit like, of course, an iPhone ripoff. A lot of people say that when it comes to the back cover, but when it comes to design, actually HTC had that design with the lines and the all-round edges and full metal body 2 years before the new iPhone. So actually it's not really a ripoff. Maybe when it comes to a complete flat design, then you could maybe say that. Now on the right side, we have a quite beautiful on and off switch, which is just a standard button to press, but you can definitely feel that this is a different button than the volume rocker, and it's on the perfect height here for your thumb, even though when you have smaller hands. On the top, there is nothing, no infrared port, no anything else anymore, just a lot of plastic for the antennas, so you have a really good signal when it comes to GPS, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, or anything else. LTE 4G is, of course, also built in. You can wake up the phone by double tapping it, or obviously you have here on the bottom this little area which is touch. You can just really, as you were able to see, just press it a little bit. There's no real button, this is just a little touchpad area like you know from your notebook maybe, and once you put your finger on it, it will also unlock. You can also just put your finger right away on it here completely, and it is right away inside the phone, and it's really fast. It's not slower than the latest iPhone, for example, the 6S or the 6S Plus. I showed that to you actually in a comparison video, so check that out later. So as I said before, beautiful device, 5 inches, full HD display, 2100 milliamp battery, which lasts quite long. You can see here the battery life right now is at 63%. In around 10 minutes, it should go down 2 to 3%. But obviously, we have here quite a high display brightness thanks to the backlight that's coming from above, and otherwise we will do a lot of gaming, and what we can do also is just go, for example, into a browser and open up anything, like, for example, here this German news site, or we could also type in here on the keyboard the New York Times. Actually also says it already right there, so we can open that just up, and then you're able to see, of course, we have here fast Wi-Fi where we are at right now, but it's also quite quick to just use in any way. There's no high-end processor again inside, just a Snapdragon 617, which actually also supports the quick charging 2 and 3. So the charger that's inside the box of this device has 1500 milliamps, but actually you can buy another charger which will have more milliamp hours inside, so you can charge it in not only 1.5 hours but in less than an hour with a software update in the future. So check that definitely out. Sorry for that. So let's open up maybe some video so we can check out the speaker, because the speaker is actually also a Dolby speaker, Dolby certified speaker. Let's go here to maybe YouTube, go to the search, and then we can, for some reason there is a Lady Gaga here search term in there, I don't know why. Actually what we can do is also just the Bieber, Boy. It's anyhow, quite popular, the What Do You Mean video. So you can see also the picture quality is really good. Doesn't feel slow at all. There's no dual speakers on the front, it's just on the bottom, this single speaker, but still. So this is PG, not 12 or 14. Let's kill that again. Let's continue with some other apps, like for example a little bit of gaming. You guys know Lara Croft is the game I'm usually showing, since it is available for different devices, needs a lot of graphics power, and actually is also quite good looking and needs also a little bit of GPU. So let's just wait till it loads up. Even though we have 3 gigs of RAM, it usually takes quite long, and I don't know why. The iPhone is definitely faster with only 2 gigs of RAM, which is always quite interesting to see. And why that loads, I can actually show you, for example, the Samsung Galaxy S6 here right next to it, that we have not the same size. The Samsung is smaller, but actually the display is bigger with 5.1 inches. In terms of thickness, they're about the same, but the Samsung has a little bit of a bigger battery than 2100. I think it's at 2300. Let's unlock it again, and oh, the game killed itself for some reason. So while it still loads, we can again compare, for example, also with the HTC One M9. In terms of thickness, you can definitely see the M9 was thicker, but has the same display size and the same size when it comes to the whole device size. So let's just continue here the game. Somehow, come on. It's quite strange here. Let's just kill them all and open it up again. While that happens, I can also show you, for example, an LG G4 smartphone, which is a 5.5 inch device, and it's exactly the same size except for it when it comes to the width. So when I put both on top of each other, you can see that in terms of the width, the LG is a little bit wider, but otherwise we have the same height roundabout. So that's quite interesting to see, that you can buy also a 5.5 inch device in the case of a 5 inch device. But HTC was never good in hiding here these spaces, and actually this speaker is only for phone calls, and we have a really good ultra pixel camera. I will go in detail in just a second when we finished gaming. I don't know why it takes so long, probably because I don't have Google games installed, so it cannot sync my status between different accounts. Come on. Here we go. Seems a little bit buggy. It's quite strange. In the German video, it worked fine, and I just killed all the apps except for this one. So there's actually really nothing anymore in the background that would hold it down. But once it's running smooth. You can see I'm still in the tutorial phase. But the graphics look really beautiful, the full HD screen is looking good, but still there's a few slow parts in this game. So let's just close it down. Okay, so let's go to the camera. One important thing about the camera is we have 30 megapixel on the back and a dual flash. It sticks out a little bit and looks a little bit also like the iPhone camera, but the iPhone is on the side, and this one has actually an optical image stabilizer inside that only the 6 Plus has, 6S Plus has. The 6S doesn't have that, even though this is the same size as the 6S. So for example, when you just do videos with your free hand, they will look quite good. You can see it here. Or for example, I was filming here on Ibiza in Spain. Few things, and they're not really that shaky and looking alright, but the focus seems always a little bit slow. And what's also strange is that you cannot zoom while you are in the video mode. I will show you that in a second when we are actually in the camera section. Also, when you go and shoot low light or pictures that don't have that good light, like for example at a dinner table where you don't always have the perfect light, and you go a little bit closer, you can see it's a little bit mushy and doesn't look sharp, and the food is looking alright, but not as delicious as it was in real life. Also, for example, when you just shoot a picture on the street, for example here at night in Munich, you can see the first picture was not really sharp, but the second one is a little bit sharper, so you have to really keep your hand steady. For example, when you had a few beers, that's not always that handy if you want to still shoot a nice picture, like for example here of the vodka, everything is really not that, well, sharp. But during the daylight, for example, with the front camera, which is an ultrapixel camera, you can shoot quite nice pictures with 4 megapixels. You can see, for example, my beard is also sharp, and you can see my wrinkles. With the front camera, but again here, daylight with the regular camera on the back. For example here, picture of the Alps, it looks all right, but when once you go a little bit closer, you will always see little fragments and that it's just not really that sharp. And even though it's 30 megapixel, other devices with the same amount of pixels just look better, like for example by Samsung, and even the Apple devices just have a better sharpness and also macro functions. My favorite feature was though the time-lapse feature. So when you take a picture or want to take a video and want to speed it up, for example here, you can see here the original. Actually, this was the original, and you can see it here. We have below this lady that's doing yoga here at the water a little bit of space, and I could tap on here to edit that time-lapse or hyperlapse feature from 6 times speed to 8 times speed, 10 or 12 times. Now 12 times is really quite nice because you can see really how fast everything happens, and therefore a 4-minute video will after that only be just 20 seconds, and you can see here really how good the optical image stabilizer is because I'm holding the camera or the smartphone still for 4 minutes and it's still not that shaky. But what you can also see is the lady on the bottom is almost not in the picture anymore since it actually crops the picture to 720p. So 720 pixels in height, which is not that great if you ask me. Because with other phones you can shoot 4K videos and then edit them later, for example, with an app down to also 4K, but just hyperlapsing them. But still, this feature is quite nice by HTC, and the result will look like this, for example. But it just looks nice on a phone or on Facebook maybe, but on a regular bigger screen, like for example your TV, it will just look all blurred. And you cannot zoom in here, but it would be quite nice if they would add a full HD hyperlapse feature. For example, I was also ice skating, and you can see here the result looks also right, especially when it comes to optical image stabilization. You can really see it's all right to watch, but just not as sharp as I want it to be. And of course, as good in quality as maybe another phone would be. And what we will do now is obviously open up the camera and show you all that those features. So for example here, let's just have something in the picture. I'm right now in the Pro area where I can really set up different things like the white balance, ISO, the focus. So I can, for example, focus not on the HTC logo but on the camera here, and I could just say the focus should be here. Or actually, this is not the focus is right here. The focus should be somewhere in the front or the back. This was all right here with the auto feature, and you can just really set up the focus to be in the back or in the front, and everything else is also manually easy to set. And you can also select between RAW and JPEG, which is really quite awesome. But I think most people will just use the regular camera mode, where you can see that we have 33 minutes left that we can record in full HD right now on the 32 gig version. And once I start recording, I can show you now here one interesting thing that I said before: you cannot zoom while recording. This is quite strange to me. Other phones allow it. I know the quality won't be as good because it's just a digital zoom, but no way possible you can zoom, which is quite strange. You can take a screenshot, you can pause the video and continue it later, but you cannot zoom, and you could also turn on the light during the video. That's also all right. Then we have here the feature to HDR. We have also a few camera options, like for example we could do 13 megapixel at 4x3 or the 10 megapixel 16x9 and so on and so on. The maximum resolution is full HD. As I said, no 4K. You can also do multiple shots if you would want that by just holding down the camera button. And you can also take, for example, slow motion and hyperlapse. Hyperlapse I showed you before. It looks like the regular camera, but it will only record in 720p and at a lower speed, so not as many pictures per minute. And with the slow motion, of course, that's something that sport people will love and like. And then with the selfie camera, you can see it here, the quality is quite good. You can again adjust here the beauty mode, so the wrinkles go a little bit away, but otherwise you have only just the HDR feature, and again the possibility to change the megapixel, what the camera button should do, and video quality is also full HD, but you can check out my sample videos on my YouTube channel, so definitely go there. So the main reason for me to buy this phone would be because the beautiful design, it's really slim, light, the battery life is quite good. You can see here 57% still right now, with having to do a lot in the camera and other apps like gaming. But the main reasons I would not buy this phone is definitely that we only can record in full HD videos. I like the 4K feature, and that it's really too big of a phone for too small of a screen. So 5 inches in this size is just not for me, even though the fingerprint reader is great, which you can also use as a home button. But I miss, for example, gestures on here that other companies like ZUK from Lenovo can do. And so this is my verdict and my full review of the HTC One A9. It's a nice phone, but it should cost less than $300-$350. Then it will be nice. Here in Germany it costs almost $600, so that's just too much. Thank you for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe. My name is Balazs. Until next time, peace and love again.